I'm doing surface mount work. Some of the cleaners, and I use them, you get them in a can, in a spray can with the nifty little spray top, and they have a brush built into them. The problem with those is, as you tilt the can, the pickup tube becomes uncovered, and then it can't spray it. This system has, now you can use this as a normal spray can, but you get this nifty little handle here, okay, that has the brush, and I've been playing with this stuff, and I like it. But it has this really nice heavy-duty stainless steel jacket on the outside. This is depressed all the time. That's just like you pulling the trigger. You get a little rack for it that hangs on the side of your bench, keeps it off the bench, valuable bench space. So for starters, you're not holding a 12-ounce big spray can in your hand. You just got this little thing. Fits right in the palm of your hand. There's a lot of bristles there, so I like that. Especially if you buy the kit, they have like a starter kit, comes with the handle, one spray can, the holder, and a pack of their lint-free highly absorbent wipes, and that's these, and they're a woven. Now normally I use chem wipes, so one place you really don't want to use chem wipes is surface mount, because they're low lint, they're not lint free. That's the problem. Just getting a little piece of lint on the board before you put the part on it, that could be a make or break it bad solder joint. But these are circuit board wipes. That's what these are made for. They're not cheap there, however. None of this is cheap. But there are cases where I'd like to use this, and I've found some advantages to this. For starters, it doesn't smell very bad. SPR, the super clean. It's non-flammable. Big thumbs up there. Some of those cleaners, man, they're hard on the nose. This isn't. Actually has a halfway pleasant, almost citrusy, and they do make a citrus-based one, but works really well. So we got lots of Flux residue there. You just give her a squirt, get a little bit of the solvent out, and you can see that stuff's caked on there because it's still there. Even, you know, it's not liquid. Now this stuff over here, yeah, the instant I touch that, you can see that RMA, that Kingbo Flux, because like I say, that stays basically, a gel is gone. There is a super heavy-duty layer of this stuff on here. Yeah, the RMA Flux is already off. The RA Flux over here, that residue's still there a little bit. But I really baked that stuff on there. And like I say, I had a lot of it. And you have to remember, there's also Flux in the solder that I was using. Again, this is almost a torture test for this stuff. The amount of Flux residue, that is not normal, normal Flux residue. Normally you'd have just a little bit, and that would be it. Actually, on the bottom side, yeah, there's a little bit of Flux residue there, because remember, I did solder that, so that would be more practical and a normal cleanup. There's some crusty Flux residue. This circuit board is like early 1980s vintage, so that Flux has been on there for a long, long time. So that's a good test of a Flux remover. It's coming off fairly easily. Now, IPA, I can tell you right now, just from experience, it would have taken a lot more scrubbing than that to get it off. Yeah, it's gone. That cleaned up very fast. You use this stuff, man, this stuff dries fast. It does not leave that white, chalky residue. You usually see the boards, they're nice and shiny. Well, they weren't when I got done cleaning all the Flux residue off. They had that white haze on the board. You don't have that problem with that stuff. It doesn't leave that film.